Hello students, today I am going to take your next class of science, that is chapter 8. Chapter 8, Man, the Living Machine. In the previous class, I have just explained you about the sense organs and the organs, the first organ, that is the respiratory organs or respiratory system. Then today I am just going to explain about the digestive system. In the previous class I have just told about the sense organs, that is the, we have the organs, that is the sense organs are eye, ear, nose, tongue. These are actually the sense organs, and it is the external organs of our body that you can easily see, and it has a different functions as I have explained yesterday. And our internal organs, that is our stomach, heart, lung, kidney, etc. These also has the separate functions for what our body functions properly. Okay, that's today I am going to just explain you about the digestive system. This I have just drawn a diagram of the digestive system. So when we intake food, this is your food pipe. When we eat food, something when we eat or smell food, when we smell food, then digestion actually starts from there only. What do you mean by digestion? Digestion means when we eat food, the food is break down into the simpler form, and this simpler form is break down with the help of the digestive fluid, and this fluid is then used by our body. That is called the digestion. The process of changing of food into simpler form due to the digestive fluid and can be used by our body is called digestion. Okay, the process of changing of food into simpler form by the use of the digestive fluid and can be used by our body is called the digestion. So you can understand here, when we eat any food, okay, and we have saliva, and then the food mixes with the saliva and it mixes with saliva and turns into the small pieces, and the food becomes a soft. So after that, what happened? This food transfer into the stomach. Here means here we form the mouth, we eat the food, and here we have saliva. In our tongue, we have saliva, that is called the digestive juice. When it mixes with the food, it turns the food into the small pieces. That pieces will be become soft, and this is your food pipe. Through food pipe, it comes into the stomach. Here the stomach, what happened in the stomach? Also the digestive juices are there. This again food part where foods are turned into the small pieces, and after that what happened in the stomach, after mixing with the digestive juices, it just transferred to the small intestine. In the small intestine, what happened? The food goes into the small intestine and the digestive food is taken by the blood. Okay, and this blood then transfer the food to the rest part of the body. Okay, so what happened? First we eat the food, with the help of the saliva the food is changed into the small pieces. After that through food pipe it goes to the stomach, and there also it mixes with the digestive juices, and this is again that transferred to the small intestine. There digested food is taken by the blood and it transferred to the rest part of the body. And what about the undigested food? Some undigested food are also there, and that undigested food are then taken by the transferred to the large intestine, and through large intestine it comes on the to the pancreas. So this is the way of the digestive system. Okay, I think all of you understand this one. Then our the next topic is the circulatory system. This one is generally the circulatory system is the heart, blood, and the blood vessels make up the circulatory system. Generally the heart, the blood vessels and the blood together make the circulatory system. What happens here, the blood of different parts of the body, these blood vessels are transferred to the blood to the different parts of the body. Here in the heart, what happened, artery and vein is the there, and the blood vessels take away and transfer towards the blood to the rest part of the body. Artery take away the blood, and the vein take back towards the heart. Like this way it transfer the blood to the rest of the part body. And in the higher classes you also learn about the different chambers of the heart. Now it is not required. And our heart beats up to about 60 to 100 times. Okay, then the circulatory system generally carries when it transfer the blood. The blood vessels transfer the blood to the rest part of the body. It generally carries oxygen and nutrients and hormones to cells, and it removes waste products like carbon dioxide. So this way the circulatory system is done in our human body. Okay, all of you understand this one, digestive system and the circulatory system. The next systems I will discuss in my next class. For today I just finished my class. Thank you.